I will show you how to implement front-end side sorting with 10-stack React table. So for that, first of all, we will need a sorting state. We need to import sorting state from the 10-stack React table. And now we need to modify our use React table hook on sorting change. Call our set sorting, get sorted model, and get sorted row model. This also can be imported from the 10-stack React table. And we need to provide a state. So the state will be sorting. So basically this one. Now let's create a separate component for the table cell headers, which will be sortable. So let's create a new component under data table. It will be called data table column header. This component will receive some props, so let's define the interface. So the props we will be interested in is column. It will be of type column, tData, tValue, and the title. And the title will be string. Let's import the column from React table. So now let's take the props, and the props will be data table header props of yet again tData and tValue. We need to provide those two generics for the component as well. And let's take column from the props and title. So now we can render. It will be a button of variant host. Let's do a small size, so size SM. Some additional class names like H8. And on click, what we want to do is to actually call the sorting handler, which comes from the column. So we can say column dot get toggle sorting handler. And we need to call this function. So inside of the button, we can do a span and let's render our title for the header. All right, so now we can use this component in our bank account columns. So instead of this balance header, we can say render me a data table column header component. And we need to provide some props. So the first one will be column and we need the title. So the title will be balance and the column we can get from here. All right, let's take a look whether or not it works. So the balance is a button already. I can press it. And as you can see, the sorting is happening, but we are missing the icon indicator in what direction we are sorting currently. And the other problem is that this balance header should be aligned on the right. So let's firstly fix the alignment issue. So for that, what we need to do is provide the class name. So let's do class name. And the class name will be text right. And we need to apply this class name in the data table column header component. So let's take the class name from props and let's apply that class name to the div. So class name, class name. All right, the alignment is fixed. Now we can implement the icon for the sorting direction. So let's create a function for that. Let's say const render sort icon. It will be a function and we need to do const sort and let's take the sort value from the column get is sorted. Let's call this function and as you can see this can return us either a false or a sort direction. The sort direction can be ascending or descending and if the value is false it means that this column is not being sorted on currently. So let's do if it's not sorted, we can return a chevron left right icon and rotate it by 90 degrees so that it would point up and down. Let's import the icon from the Lucid React. But if sorting value is either ascending or descending, we can do return sort equals descending. If it's descending, let's render arrow down icon. Otherwise, arrow up icon. Let's also import them. Now let's render this icon next to the title. So let's say render sort icon. And additionally, we can do one more if. So we can say if column get k can sort. And let's do a negation in the front. So basically, if this column is not able to be sorted on, we just return a simple div. All right, looks good. Let's check how it's looking. Okay, so in the beginning, we have no sort applied. So we are displaying the chevron left and right icon rotated by 90 degrees. If I press once, you can see that we are sorting in descending order. If I press one more time, the sorting direction was changed. And on the last click, the sorting was removed. Thank you for watching. Hit that subscribe button if you like this video. And in the next one, I think we will cover table row actions with edit and delete functionalities.